Today I am delivering lecture on mode of transport. Different modes of transport are used for the transportation of fruits, vegetables and flowers. The introduction of mode of transport. The basic requirement during the transport are better control of temperature, humidity and adequate ventilation. So the transportation, at the time of transportation, the main role is to maintain or to control the temperature, humidity and ventilation. In addition to produce, should be immobilized by proper packaging and staking to avoid excessive movement of vibration. So in addition of transportation is to use the well or the proper packaging material and staking to avoid the excessive movement of produce or vibration of produce. Refrigerator containers and trailers are more often used for long distance shipping, whether by sea, rail and truck. For the long distance transportation, mainly refrigerated containers are used for the transportation that can be sent by transported by sea, rail or truck. In this slide, we can see the different modes of transportation are used of horticultural produce: road transport, rail transport, marine transport, and air transport. So, first, road transport. Pre-cooled products can be transported through well-insulated, non-refrigerated trucks for up to several hours without any significant rise in product temperature. Pre-cooled, that means remove of field heat from the produce, and that product can be transported through well insulated non-refrigerated trucks. Insulated, that means the heat resistant material or heat resistant trucks. Non-refrigerated trucks are used for the transportation for the several hours without any significant rise in product temperature. There are considerable cost saving without any loss of quality if trucks are only insulated rather than refrigerated for short distance shipping. Now, for example, milk or milk tankers. Sometimes cost saving materials, that means some of trucks are only for insulated trucks can be used for the transportation, that is milk tankers. And that not that trucks are used for the transportation of milk. If and these trucks are mainly used for the short distance shipping. If the product is not pre-cooled and shipping distance is long, a ventilated truck is better choice than an insulated truck without ventilation or without refrigeration. Second thing is for the transportation of long distance, that time we can use ventilated trucks. It is better than the without ventilation or without a refrigeration truck. In this ventilated trucks, we reduces the spoilage or also increases the shelf life of products. Ventilation alone does not usually provide a uniform cool temperature, but it may help dissipate excessive field heat and respiration rate and thus avoid high temperature injury. So the ventilation does not usually provide a uniform cool temperature, but it may help in dissipate excessive field heat. Okay. Excessive field heat, this ventilation trucks can be remove the excessive field heat and a respiration rate or maintain the respiration rate and thus avoid the high temperature injury of the produce. Next one, highly perishable produce like tomato, mushroom, beans, radish are transported by road to long distance, subjected to spoilage quickly in comparison to garlic, onion, potato, etc., and need a special care while handling during transit. Okay, some of the perishable produce, for example, the tomato, mushroom, beans, and radish, this is a perishable produce, and that can be that are transported by the roads through long distance. But in this perishable produce, the spoilage is early or quickly. That produce can be quickly spoiled. But as compared to the garlic, onion, and potato, unrefrigerated road transport, closed or open-sided vehicles are mostly used for transportation during short journey, for example, between a market or packaging station at the retail outlet. There are two types of road transport. One is the unrefrigerated road transport, and second one is the refrigerated road transport. So the unrefrigerated road transport mostly used for the short distance journey. Okay, for example, between the market or the packaging station, that time you can use the unrefrigerated road transport. Next one, refrigerated road transport. Different types and capacities of refrigerated road vehicles are available for transportation of perishable goods. The cooling media may be ice, salt, dry ice, cryogens, and refrigerants. This is the cooling media. This media are used in refrigerated road transport. Ice, salt, dry ice, cryogens, and refrigerants. This media can cool down the temperature of vehicles. Today, majority of refrigerated vehicles operate on a mechanical refrigeration system. Now, these days, in vehicles, refrigerated vehicles, mechanical refrigeration system are mostly operated. A vehicle should be airtight as possible to prevent heat loss. So the vehicle should be airtight. That can help or prevent the heat loss. It should also be well insulated to prevent heat loss through exchange through floor, wall, and roof. So the heat is a loss through floor, walls, and roof. So at that time, we can use insulated vehicles. Okay. So we can prevent heat loss through exchange, floor, walls, and roof. Second one mode of transport is rail transport. First one is the road transport. This is the rail transport. Wherever possible goods, trains are important means of transportation for most of the commodities. However, the time taken by rail is sometimes more than by roads, but the cost of transportation is very cheap. Example, onion, potato, root, and vegetables. So the time requirement for the transportation of rail is more as compared to the road transport. But the cost of transportation is very cheap. And through the rail transport, we can transport the vegetables like onion, potato, root vegetables, etc. And in this rail transport, again classified unrefrigerated rail transport and refrigerated rail transport. So the first one is the unrefrigerated rail transport. As with a road transport of perishable, unrefrigerated rail transport can only be effective over relatively short distance, actually distance being influenced by a prevailing weather condition and time of transportation. So unrefrigerated rail transport mostly used for the actual relatively short distance. For the short distance only, this type of transportation are used. Then refrigerated rail transport. A rail car with a mechanical refrigeration equipment can be larger unit than that transported by a road. That is 15 to 20 meters in a length. In this refrigeration, mechanical refrigeration equipments are used in rail transport. A number of modifications can be made to rail cars. For example, a car may be modified to carry bulk produce, for example, potatoes provided with heaters for winter transportation, and chili is sensitive to produce in cool climate. car also used for the refrigeration transportation. For example, car may modify it to carry the bulk produce. That means if the potato are transported in winter season, that time we can create the environment as a heat, hot rise in temperature or hot climate. That is, heater is provided for increasing the temperature. And the winter transportation of the chili is a sensitive produce in cool climate. So that time heater is required to transport of chili in a winter season or in a cool climate. Third one mode of transportation is sea transportation. Major portion of the perishable is international trade is transported by sea. Okay, perishable vegetables or perishable horticultural produce transported in the international trade by the sea. The various method of sea transport includes ambient sea transportation, refrigerated brick bulk refrigerated containers, modified atmospheric containers, and hyperbaric containers. So the sea transportation through sea, the different methods of transportation includes like ambient sea transportation, refrigerated brick bulk refrigerated bulk, and next one is the refrigerated containers, modified atmospheric containers, hyperbaric containers. In this transportation, again classified as unrefrigerated sea transport, refrigerated sea transport, and refrigerated containers. First, unrefrigerated sea transport, the commodities which have a relatively long storage life at ambient temperature, such as garlic, onion, potato, ginger, turmeric, and others are transported in this method. That means only those vegetables are having the long shelf life that can be transported through unrefrigerated sea transport. For example, garlic, onion, potato, ginger, mostly bulb or tuber crop, rhizomes crops are transported through unrefrigerated sea transport. Next one, refrigerated sea transport. In a refrigerated ships, conditions of temperature are relative humidity are rarely held for the period over 3 weeks. In a refrigerated sea transport, the condition of temperature and relative humidity are rarely held for a previous over 3 weeks. That means the temperature or the humidity can be maintained in refrigerated sea transport. Refrigerated containers. There exist three basic types of containers, namely insulated containers, insulated ventilated containers, and temperature control containers. There are three types of containers are mainly used in transportation: insulated containers, insulated ventilated containers, and temperature controlled containers. Certain containers are also approved for the fumigation of cargo or modified to allow use of controlled atmosphere system. Okay, certain containers are mainly used for the fumigation of cargo or modified to allow the use for the controlled atmospheric system. The prepared atmosphere is placed in refrigerated containers by displacing air with specified mixture of nitrogen, oxygen, and carbon dioxide, and some trace gases. So the containers are refrigerated containers prepare the atmosphere and maintaining by displacing air with a specified mixture of gases, nitrogen, oxygen, and carbon dioxide. So these gases is helpful to maintaining to extend the shelf life of produce. Shipping of mixed loads. When mixed loads shipments are made up only commodities which have a compatible requirements. For example, temperature, modified atmosphere, relative humidity, protection of from the odors, and ethylene should be placed in a same hold. So shipping of mixed loads, in the, that means the mix of different commodities or the shipments of different, these shipments mainly made for the transportation of different commodities, and maintaining in this ship, maintaining the different climatic requirement, for example, temperature, modified atmosphere, relative humidity, protection from odors, ethylene, placed in the same hold. Next one is the waterways. This method is used among growers whose fields are situated near on a bank of river or lake. So this type of transportation mainly used for where the growers whose field are situated near the bank of river or lake. That in India, this transportation system is used only in Kashmir, Kerala, part of Andhra Pradesh and West Bengal. That means the farmers' field are situated near the river or lake. It is aid to be developed for the quick and easy disposal of perishable vegetables from the field, which are situated far away from a big market, but near or on the bank of river or lake. So this type of transportation is developed for quick and easy disposal of perishable vegetables from the fields to situated far away from the big basket. Last one is the air transportation. This method is followed only in case of high value crops such as flowers, rare fruits, vegetables, because of the very high cost of transportation. So this is the expensive method of transportation, and through this transportation mainly rare fruits and some of the flowers and vegetables are transported through this transportation, because it is very expensive or high cost transportation method. Costs are high and loss often heavy because of poor and non-standard packages, careless handling and exposure to the elements at airports, then consignments left behind in a favor of passengers, flight delay owing to bad weather of or the breakdowns, and intermittent refrigeration followed by exposure to high temperature. So this is the causes of loss may be occur during the transportation, air transportation. The causes of losses during non-refrigerated transportation. What type of losses can be occur when we use the non-refrigerated transportation? The damage and loss occur during non-refrigerated transport are caused primarily by mechanical damage and by the overheating. First one is the mechanical damage. Mechanical damage because of careless handling of packed produce during loading and unloading. Then next one is the vibration of vehicles because of bad condition of road. Then fast driving and poor condition of the vehicles. Poor stowage, which allows the packages in a transit to save and it stop by may collapse. Packages stack too high. The movement of produce within the package increase in relation to its height in the stack. So this is the major causes of mechanical damage. Then next one is the overheating. This can occur not only from the external source, but also from heat generated by the produce within the packages itself. Okay, overheating, that means sometimes the external source sometimes the heat is generated by the produce within packages. So that time heat overheating. Overheating promotes natural breakdown and decay, increasing the rate of water loss from produce. If the overheating is occur in a produce, that time increasing the water loss from the produce. These causes of overheating includes the use of closed vehicles without ventilation. Okay, if you use the closed vehicles without ventilation, that time overheating may be occur. Closed stop staking patterns blocking the movement of air between the two packages and thus hindering the dispersal of heat. Okay, if you transport the bulk amount of commodity or the produce in a less space, that time air circulation or the movement of air may be stopped, and that can increase the heating, that means overheat. The lack of adequate ventilation among packages themselves, lack of adequate ventilation. And exposure of packages to the sun while awaiting transport or while trucks are queuing to unload at their destination. Okay. So this is the causes of loss occur in during the unrefrigerated transportation. Factors to be considered for reducing or avoiding loss during transportation. Which factor can be considered to reducing the loss during transport? To ensure that vehicle is in a good condition, then drive the vehicle properly and smoothly. Minimize the movement of containers inside the vehicles and use horizontal drivers or dividers or racks inside the transport. So that time the air can be passed easily, or movement of air can be easily through produce. Protect commodities from sun, rain and wind. While transporting without packaging, provide sufficient cushioning on the floor and all the four sides of wall. So during the transportation, cushioning material and packaging is very important things to avoid the losses during transportation. So the cushioning material can be used on the floor and all four sides of the wall. So this is all about mode of transportation. Thank you.